Kia ora. Kia ora. Nick Korako.
A tēnā koe te mana whakawā. Ngatikahu ki Whangaroa. E mihi nei, e tangi nei. Koutou nā tōka whakahirahira. Koutou e tūmanako hia. Koutou e hāpai iwi nei. E nau mai, nau mai, nau mahara mai. E te mana whakawā. I only have a short call to acknowledge the iwi, the people of Ngatikahu ki Whangaroa. And particularly last December, it was my honour to act as a witness at the signing of the Ngatikahu ki Whangaroa deed of settlement. And I want to thank you for hosting me that day at your beautiful O Tangaroa Marae. Maururu koe, mō tau manaaki a te whai. Kia ora. E te mana whakawā, it is also my pleasure on behalf of the Māori Affairs Select Committee to welcome you here to Poneke, to welcome you here to this place. I've always enjoyed the opportunity to visit your beautiful rohe and to look forward to being there again, particularly at the fish and chip shop. Kia ora. I know this settlement has not been an easy one. I really do know that. And it was reflected when we were at your marae. We saw this, we saw the rawness that reflected the negotiations. But what I also saw there was the mana. And when Peter Whangaari actually was there, and he said to us that once upon a time I was there also. So I acknowledge you for the way that this settlement has been, particularly on a very, very difficult journey. But the journey is actually in some ways coming to an end, particularly around the treaty settlement process, and then another really important journey will start also, probably the most important one, and that is the post-settlement situation and how you will actually deal with that. Sir, I think the important thing is that I want to acknowledge one thing that is in this deed of settlement, and that is the fact that Ngatikahu ki Whangaroa have said they will forego full compensation to contribute to New Zealand's development. That is mana. And also the fact, though, we need to highlight that it is not just about that. As someone from an iwi who settled very early, as someone who has seen treaty settlements progress, almost all of our people will tell you, particularly our kaumātua, they will tell you it's not about the money, it's actually about the apology, because that there enables us to move on. But not only is it about accepting less, because less in some ways is more. And particularly when we look at the fact that this is legacy. You are actually the people, the rangatira, the whānau, that are actually trying to ensure that there is a legacy, a better legacy for your rangatahi. It's also about opportunity. Commercial, yes, but social opportunity. It's also about that opportunity, cultural and social. So, e te mana whakawā, this has been a hallmark, really, of an iwi who have shown mana. And when I travel around the north, the far north, there is, sir, I believe, a desire, particularly from the rangatahi, that they want their settlement settled, because they can see that there is another life after grievance. Finally, e te mana whakawā, our upoko runanga of Naitua Huriri, he said once, Peter Tohori, he said this in 1861, kia ata whai ki te iwi, take care of the people. Sir, this treaty settlement, this is the real essence of what these rangatira are doing here today and those that are at home listening. This is the essence, sir, of this settlement And I acknowledge you for that, and I honour you, and I commend your bill to the House. Kia ora.
Speaker.